people who would be highly motivated to go in and make the article more neutral, more politically neutral, but they're not allowed to.
Nobody should trust Wikipedia, its co-founder warns. Larry Sanger says site has been taken over by left-wing volunteers who write off sources that don't fit their agenda as fake news. Welcome to the Dum Dum News Channel, dedicated to reviewing news stories from around the world. Help me trigger the YouTube algorithm by pressing the thumbs up button, subscribing to my channel, leaving a comment, and sharing with someone you think would like this content. Sources will be linked in the description, so you can read the full details yourself. The article further states, Larry Sanger, 52, co-founded Wikipedia with Jimmy Wales in 2001. He said site has been taken over by Democratic-supporting volunteer editors. Sanger said left-leaning editors do not allow Wikipedia users to edit pages. He mentioned the Wikipedia entry on Joe Biden as example of leftist bias. Biden entry doesn't make mention of scandals and Hunter Biden laptop.
Let me go straight in with the big question then. Can we trust what we read in Wikipedia, the website you co-founded?
Well, you can trust it to give a reliably establishment point of view on pretty much everything. Can you trust it always to give you the truth? Well, it depends on what you think the truth is. What many of our media sources today, and Wikipedia included, seem to assume is that there is only one legitimate, defensible version of the truth on any controversial question. Of course, that's not how Wikipedia used to be.
Well, let's get into that, because that's fascinating. How do you feel that it's changed from the moment when you were involved to the modern version of Wikipedia?
When Wikipedia was just entering the public eye, it was still committed to neutrality, actually. And for several years, like between 2004 and 2009 or so, Wikipedia actually was a kind of an important player in the conversation about how new media were going to emerge. People were talking a lot about collaboration and neutrality was one of them. But it was very interesting in that you could go to an article about a U.S. president or about some hot button issue or some controversial news event, and you actually would see multiple different points of view reasonably fairly laid out. And if that weren't the case, then people would get on what's called the talk page of Wikipedia, and they would actually battle it out, and different sides would have a chance of having their points of view heard. Moreover, it was a lot easier back then for people to participate. So I'm talking about what I have in mind is about 2004, 2005, just as Wikipedia started to become a household name, essentially. Even then, you could get on an article, at least on a second tier topic. Maybe the most important topics were already like unmanageably difficult for the ordinary person to participate in. But there were lots of opportunities where there were not people who were sitting constantly on an article and trying to make it say what they wanted it to say. That was already going on, but not nearly as bad as today. Now, especially over the last 5 years or so, Wikipedia has changed, as you indicate, quite a bit.
It's
really hard to participate. On a lot of articles, if you go in and you make any edit at all, you will be sternly warned, if not just kicked out. And it doesn't matter if it's a completely positive edit. This sometimes even happens on articles that are unimportant.
Why is that happening?
Because I think there is a lot of influence. Wikipedia is known now by everyone to have a lot of influence in the world. And so there's a very big, nasty, complex game being played behind the scenes to make the articles say what somebody wants them to say, right?
Well, people actually employ paid consultants, don't they, to constantly be tending to their Wikipedia entries. So it's become the kind of battleground for the official version of truth. So there's a huge value to what your Wikipedia entry says.
Right, right. I mean, there are companies called like WikiPR and things like that where paid writers and editors will go in and change articles. maybe there is some way to make such a system work, but not if the players who are involved and who are being paid are not identified by name. They actually are supposed to be identified by name and saying, well, we represent this firm. If they are officially like registered with some sort of Wikipedia editing firm. But they don't have to do that because there is no requirement of real names, in fact. In fact, because, as I say, it's a very complex sort of game, there's all kinds of tricks that people can play to win it.
Let's look into some examples then, just to help people sort of understand what we're talking about. How about politics? I mean, one thing you've actually written about is that the entry for Barack Obama is very different to the entry to Donald Trump, which I suppose you would expect, they being very different people and very different parties and politics. But what were you observing there, and what was it that worried you?
Can I change the example? I'm in the middle of writing another blog post about Biden, for example. So the Biden article, if you look at it, has very little by way of the concerns that Republicans have had about him. So if you want to have anything remotely resembling the Republican point of view about Biden, you're not going to get it from the article. And there is like a paragraph, I believe, in it is quite a long article about Biden. And so there should be at least a paragraph about the scandal involving, the Ukraine scandal. Let's just put it that way. It's very complicated.
This is involving Hunter Biden and his involvement. This was the topic that was much talked about, and there were questions over whether it was censored, it was banned off various social media platforms, the New York Post was involved. It was a huge deal earlier in the year.
Exactly. And very little of that can be found in Wikipedia. What little it can be found is extremely biased and reads like a defense counsel's brief, really.
How does that happen then? Is it because there are sort of teams of Democrat leading editors who are there to excise it if it gets added, or is it that Republican leading people just aren't bothering to contribute?
I'm pretty sure it's the first. I think that there are a lot of people who would be highly motivated to go in and make the article more neutral, more politically neutral, but they're not allowed to.
In my opinion, I am not surprised that people have ruined something for their cause. There is so much money and power at stake that ethics goes out the window with these people. If you remember, when AOC complained that her grandmother didn't get financial aid from the government in Puerto Rico, a right-leaning commentator raised over $100,000 for her that AOC blocked her grandmother from getting. I can go on and on here, but I'll just say you can no longer trust what you read on Wikipedia. Those are my thoughts. What are yours? Leave them in the comments below. Please share this video for education and awareness. For the Dum Dum News Channel, I'm Dum Dum.